making the trip down to Kardinia Park. Last year, Geelong had thrashed them both times. Remember once, Gary Ablett kicked 14 goals. But the champ wasn't there today. Let's take a look at the scores to half-time. And it was pretty even at quarter-time and even closer at half-time. Geelong squandering opportunities to be 5-15, Richmond 6-8, the Cats leading by a point. We're going to pick up the replay tonight into the third quarter. 20 minutes remaining, each team has kicked a point. Geelong still lead by a point. And the commentators are Sandy Roberts, Dennis Cometti and Don Scott.
5-16, plays 6-9. Rogers to the outer side. Flanagan just spoiling from behind. Hughes in front down to Hocking. Sweeps it wide to Gary. Mitchell closes on him. Gets a kick under pressure, but only as far as Powell. Powell swings back in towards the half forward line once again and again finds Gale.
Good kick.
Call to play on. A flat looking punt kick out to half forward. No mark taken. The chance is there for the Tigers. Trying to get clear and eventually doing so is Desrine. And makes no mistake. So again, the Tigers open up this 5-point lead, 7-9, 51. Geelong a 5-16, 46.
Well, I don't believe Des Ryan could believe his luck. That second goal, he seemed to spin at the right time, came out, no one around at all. And they don't happen very often, situations such as that, but he appreciated and kicked a goal. Des Ryan.
So the Tigers are looking good. We're back in the middle. Flanagan over the top. Cameron. Nicely done. Couch wobbles one down towards half forward. Grand mark taken by McKellar. Fell over, kept his eye on the ball. This is Bannock on the burst. Out wide, the target out there is Pickering. He's taken the mark. Michael Pickering started brilliantly. Goes down towards half forward, two on one down there. Mitchell has got it, hits the ground running. Look at him go, Michael Mitchell from 55. Long, it may go through for a goal. Oh, why did he touch it? Why did he touch it?
I asked the same question.
Oh, Jeff Hogg. Well, I can't say we didn't raise the matter. 7-10 to 5-16. Rogers wasting no time. Towards the outer side. Nobody touched that one. Mitchell left it behind. Buse gets the hand pass away. This is Sterrett. Into Cloak. Hocking back to Sterrett. Towards half forward. Powell's in front.
Playing well. And Richmond now in top gear. And looking dangerous.
Leading by 6 points. Over the centre. Hocking. Buse. Robert Scott. Or Cameron. Oh. The way they're travelling at the moment. We'll finally have a bounce.
Michael Pickering not too good, Sandy. Centre half forward position for Richmond. He's holding his shoulder. His right shoulder. After he came to ground and the pack fell down on top of him.
Here's the bounce. Flanagan wins it, then locks arms. It'll be a free kick and it'll go the way of Richmond. Taken by Barry Ryan. Barry Young. Barry Ryan had that hit song, didn't he? Malakellis. Out of bounds on the full. So the Tigers to go forward again. And Darcy backing into the pack takes it at half back. Tim Darcy to repel this Richmond attack. Cats a little shell-shocked at the moment. Cameron over the back. Scott tries to force his way through the pack. Cameron is claimed. Through it, said the umpire. So Richmond again a chance to go forward through Cloak. McKellar is wide. Klein. Assistance from Ryan. Bannock on the boundary line. Cloak sweeping it inside to Powell. Wide to Waitman. Danger here for the Cats as the Tigers go forward. Good looking kick. And a mark taken by Hogg.
Are they playing confidently? Logg was on the lead before Waitman had the ball. And it was good spotting by Waitman because he was running to right of screen. Hogg was left of screen, hooked the ball back. A natural thing for a right footer. Good effort.
So Jeff Hogg. This to make the margin 12 points. And again, pulling it to the left.
His kicking lets him down, doesn't it?
So both sides. Back it comes to Justin Pickering. He finds Powell just inside the boundary line.
Geelong handling the ball too much, trying to run it through the centre with handball. They should be using kicks.
Powell, high kick. Des Ryan in front. Falls to Waitman. Superbly done to Gale. He runs to 50. Has he got the accuracy? No. Well, Richmond have had a chance the last 5 minutes or so to take a strong grip on this game, but they're not finishing. Hamilton comes onto the ground for the Cats.
One goal four they've kicked so far this quarter.
Rogers kicking in, virtually straight down the middle. Flanagan in front, Gale misses behind. Hamilton immediately in the action. McCrabb gets the hand pass away. View's in trouble. McCrabb only as far as Knights. Nichols, now he's on his natural foot, running to the left side. He settles. He goes goal when he kicks it.
So a great goal for the Tigers. They move further ahead, 8-12-60, leading by 14 points over Geelong, 5-16-46.
Well, they're very preoccupied with handball, Geelong. On that half-back line then, it was handball that got them into trouble. It was cut out by Richmond. I would like to see a kick, especially when you're under pressure, just a kick down the ground, get some yardage, then the pretty stuff can come a little later when you're playing with confidence. But at the stage, Geelong not playing with confidence. I'll just have to get back to Tours.
Centre bounce. Waitman again, taking it out of the middle for the Tigers. Down towards Barry Young. With him is Gurry. Gurry too quick this time. Looks for Malakellis. He gets bundled out in the process. The Richmond desperation really starting to show out. Knight supplies the tackle. Heading for the boundary line was Hamilton. Cameron there, right at the back. Mitchell is there also. He shoots towards goal and pumps for another one.
The Tigers looking for their second victory of the season. Flanagan wins it down. Sterrett away to Poole towards half forward. No mark taken. Brownless to Stoneham. 55 metres out. Was he tripped? Yes, says the umpire. So Stoneham, normally a very good kick.
Brownless will have to get down to the goal square quicker than what he's doing. Now he's on a lead. Now Stoneham can only go long. And look at the Richmond or the Geelong forward line. It's too small. He's got to kick a score here.
This game has come alive. Stoneham, a massive kick. A metre out. Nixon gets a fist on it, and it's a minor score. Smiling goal umpire. Five 17 the Tigers, or rather the Cats. 9-12 the Tigers. Bannock, the short one. Ryan, that's Stephen Ryan. Across to Nixon, around the outer side. Stoneham has played very well all day. One of the few Geelong players who can make that claim. Takes the mark. Missed kicks, though. Flanagan, missed by Hamilton. Coming through was Ryan. That's Des Ryan. On his knees, gets the hand pass away. Gurry, in deep trouble. Bodies at the ball. Views with courage. Picked it up. Got the hand pass away. Brownless, too slick for Hamilton. Claimed by Pickering. Play goes on. Michael Pickering, the hand pass to McKellar. Lively stuff, this. McKellar towards the outer side. Ball runs free. Mitchell, like lightning, confronted by Malakellis. It's three against two. McCrabb did superbly and wins the free kick.
Well, he had to go then, Austin McCrabb, and it's good to see he did.
Got Couch earmarked. Powell comes in and affects the spoil. Richmond have gone up yet another gear. Couch on the defensive side of centre. Caught, Waitman leaves it for Nichols. Pickering in trouble. Couch. Free kick to Pickering.
Is it the same game?
Well, Geelong have got no one to blame except themselves. The warning signs were there just after half-time, and that have led Richmond back into this game.
They trail by 21 points, and this man has kicked three of their goals. There's Ryan. Brownless sets itself, Gales from the back.
Yes, I agree. I agree on that occasion. That fellow has got a lot of potential, Gale, and it's a good effort to take a mark over Brownless because Brownless has got an incredible leap. And he is well within kicking distance.
And he kicks this, the margin's 27 points. It would be fair to say the cat is well and truly amongst the pigeons. Kicks on its way, and I fear off target, one behind. So the score here at Kardinia Park, Richmond are 9-13, 67, the Cats are 5-70.
Rogers kicking in, big pack into the air. Pickering has done very well to Ryan, to Waitman, he's been busy too, in trouble, gets the hand pass away, down towards the pocket. Back goes Cameron, it's out of bounds and will be thrown in. Well, it was quiet early in this game. The crowd almost expecting, I think, Geelong to run away with it. But Richmond have been strong. Lee, show of strength there, holding the ball that time. And Rogers, I think, will get the free kick. Wants to play on. No conviction about them at the present time. Flanagan, that's better. Strong mark. Flanagan.
Where is going to kick the ball, Dennis? The Richmond fellows completely outnumber the Geelong fellows. That's why Flanagan is taking so long to get rid of it.
Flanagan hugs the boundary line. That was the best option. Stoneham was there, but again they lose it. Powell to Gale. Waitman. Waitman wide. Mitchell spilled it, should have marked that one. Malakellis with dash, look at him go, with his leg. Malakellis will get the free, but not a bad one to concede there.
My word, a good professional free kick there by Mitchell because Malakellis was off.
Squares it. Gurry's got it now, up from half back. Goes in short, David Cameron has run inside. He pops it over the top, Bewes, down towards right half forward, Andrew Bewes.
Too slow into the forward line.
Thought about playing on, but now goes back.
Played well.
The Cats skipper up towards the forward pocket area again. Hinton. His hand pass is not a good one under pressure. Sterrett may make amends, but Pickering is quick to put his body over the ball.
That's just the mark difference between the two sides. On that little bit of play there, Sterrett more or less went in one hand, Pickering threw his body in. Just to hold up play. That's the difference between the two sides at the moment. Richmond want the ball a bit more.
20 points favouring the Tigers. Bewes with strength gets it out. The Cats need a goal. That's coming back, but yet another behind goes on the board. Gary Cameron off target. And they move to within 19 points. 5-18. Richmond a 9-13. Bannock again. To the outer side, no mark taken. Scott in front of the pack from 35 metres. He steadies, chips towards goal and hits the post again.
It's unbelievable. That's happened about three times today that Geelong players, when the ball is kicked out, are that side of the pack, not picked up. On one occasion there was two, that time one, but inconceivable that can happen.
Fourth point to Robert Scott, kicked two goals four.
See what happens this time. Bannock finds his mark. That was Pickering. Sweeping it wide to his brother. Now a chance for the Tigers to run the ball down as Nixon goes up towards Gale. Hogg gives him a lead. Here he comes. Can't take it.
Yes, I agree with the umpire.
Lyo plays on with the advantage. Still in there with a chance. Stoneham looks to steal it and does. Gives it to Darcy and the Cats out of strife. Back towards Poole on the halfback flank. Trevor Poole centres it for Couch. Away he goes, out in front of Scott, intercepted by Pickering. The Tigers are playing inspired football. Pickering's kicked the half forward. And he finds Des Ryan. He's got a player loose in Waitman down in the pocket, but decides to go the other way. McKellar. And another good mark taken by Hogg.
Let's talk about that last situation with Hogg. It was a push in the back. The umpire awarded the free, 40 metres out, then paid the advantage. Umpires, when a player is within scoring range, have got to stop it. Otherwise, that cost Richmond a goal.
Jeff Hogg looking for his second. He's been off target. It looks better. It's another one to the Tigers. So Richmond move further ahead. 10-13-73. Geelong stunned on 5-19-49.
Well, that makes up for that free kick earlier from Hogg. I disagree with Dennis. There was advantage played. Richmond were carrying the ball forward. They were intent in playing on. The umpire making the right decision, paying the advantage. It just didn't come off. 2-3 to Hogg.
Well, it's a moot point, Don. When is advantage an advantage? This is Cameron out of the centre. High towards half forward. McKellar. Scott did well. Emerges with the ball, but McKellar's going to get a free kick. McKellar. Not in the original 20. It's replaced Lambert. Nichols towards centre wing. This is Hamilton. It's all Richmond. Hamilton long into the forward line. Lees the target. Off his hands. Brownless. Swooping on it, Mitchell, strong tackle, Brownless, Waitman inside the Young. Young from 20 metres out, there's another one. The Tigers on fire.
Final quarter, Geelong have added a point, the margin 29 points. If the Cats can get straight, they can still be in it. It's down to a thriller as we rejoin our commentators at Kardinia Park.
Comes towards Powell. Mitchell able to hold out Hamilton. So Powell from the back pocket. Towards the wing. Brownless gets front spot. Play on is the call. Off to Malakellis. Wide to Hughes. Hughes' kick is good. So the Cats have yet another opportunity. David Cameron hasn't goaled to date.
I wonder whether that was an intentional pass by Andrew Hughes. Didn't look good off the boot, but nonetheless, he was in front, Cameron.
He shoots towards goal. Can the Cats come back? That's the start. Cameron kicks his first, and Geelong sixth. 6:21:57, trailing Richmond, 11:14:80.
Well, he's been a prolific goal kicker, David Cameron, since he has come from Echuca. Initially, he played with the Fitzroy under-19s. And it's amazing that Fitzroy let him go. He went back to Biak and then to Echuca, and now is at Geelong, and a real headache at that forward pocket position in past games.
23 points the margin. Geelong aided by a slight breeze in this final term. Knights comes away from the centre towards half forward. Hocking goes back, didn't mark it, finds it on the ground in deep trouble, gets the hand pass away. McCrabb, great composure, squares the ball. Slipping over was Hamilton, kept his eye on the ball. Free down the ground is Malakellis. He's got it now, well, almost. Now he has. He's on centre wing. Away he goes. Runs through centre, kicks to half forward. Strong mark is taken down there by Hinckley. Hit the ground running, got the hand pass away. Couch goes long, he's off target. And the ball is out of bounds on the full.
I know he's carrying an ankle. I just wonder how bad that ankle is, because he really didn't kick that ball with any real conviction, although it covered 45 metres. And it might have been smothered off the boot, or he might have been pushed as he was kicking the ball, but I've got a query about that.
That's the indication by the umpire. Touched upfield. Throw in. Cloak towards the boundary line.
It's a good hit out by Cloak in that situation.
It will be thrown in. Powell showing a lot of desperation in there, as he's done all day. Flanagan and Cloak. Cloak to the front. Hughes slung off it. Deep in the pocket and going nowhere was Cameron. It's out of bounds once more.
Got to open it up a bit in that forward line, Geelong. You can see they're playing into Richmond's hands. That ball coming forward of the pack.
Flanagan and Cloak. Cloak in front. Waitman. Ball held. Another bounce.
Good tackle there by Cameron.
Andrew Bewes, hands on hips, but he's been a trier all day as Cloak hammers it defensively towards the line.
He's taken over at the moment.
Both Cloak and Lee have done the job asked of them today. Here he is again with Flanagan. Cloak wins it. Pickering to Ryan. Again out of strife, the Tigers. He bounces his way across half-back, then kicks towards the wing. Hamilton is his target. Can't take the mark, but recovers well. Looking for Nichols. Couch intercepts. Couch is claim. He's lost it. Knights towards Waitman. Drifted down towards half forward. Short again, Gale. And he marks inside 50.
He's kicked 4 points. Can this be his first goal? All those points coming in the third quarter.
Brendan Gale will kick from just inside 50 metres, and if he kicks this, it will make it very difficult for Geelong. Over the back, and still kept in play. The end result is one behind. +11.15 plays 6.21. After that, behind from Pickering. Rogers back into play. Flanagan in front. The Cats have got to get a wriggle on. Flanagan gets it out. Now a chance for them to run. Couch bounces his way through the centre with 3 bounces. Then stabs it long in towards half forward. Cameron in the pack. Stone him a chance. Can he pick it up and get the handball wide? It's not wide enough.
And getting it free.
Free kick. It's coming back. Stoneham's holding his ear. So suddenly, after Richmond had the chance to score, Geelong have rushed it down the other end of the ground. This to make the margin 18 points.
Exuberance of Goodwin. A disadvantage to Richmond on that occasion.
35 metres out. Stoneham shoots. I think he may have just snuck it in. He has. So the Cats are still alive.
Outstanding second half, this one. Still plenty of time. Mitchell knocked away by Sterrett. Off the ground by Couch. Towards half forward. Hamilton's got the run of it. Powell is there. Hughes rides one bump. Shakes the tackle. Comes around from 40. Pulls it back across his body. Goodwin had his fingertips to it. It hit the post.
Well, what strength he's got, Hughes. That was strength that got him away on that occasion. He's a very strong in the body, Andrew Hughes. You can see him bounce. He kept his composure, he's kept his balance.
He looked so cool, didn't he? Here's Bannock. He's been impressive today. Straight up the middle. Cloak's the target. He opts out. Nixon flew. Cameron dragged down. McKellar got the hand pass away to Cloak to Knights. Now he's away through centre wing. Long kick. Hogg is the target. It falls in short. Gurry got a fist on it. Diving on it down there is Gale to Waitman. What can the champ do? Gets it to Hogg. He's 25 metres out. Pulls it back too much. Almost the mark down there to Ryan. Knocked away. Brownless. He was watching the program this morning. Breaks away, kicks it towards the outer side. It bounces out of bounds in front of Mitchell and will be thrown in.
Good kick by Brownless.
It's a free kick for a push, is it? Malakellis
takes it from half back. Kicks in towards Flanagan. Cloak in late. And Flanagan will want to pump this long into the forward line. Long and low. Sterrett loose on the flank. But sits, he's in business. Oh, he's going to get himself into strife. Gives it to Stoneham from a standing start. Flicks it high into the forward line. 2 Richmond players collide with one another. It gives Cameron a chance. He kicks across the face of goal.
Oh, well done.
Trevor Paul in the pocket.
He made yardage on that occasion, Paul. He really did make yardage to get that ball. It was a good effort.
...25 metres, very tight angle. Look at him, right on the boundary line. He'll erupt if he kicks this. He's on the right side. He's kicked it. He has kicked. So the margin is now just 11 points. 11-15 Richmond. Geelong are 8-22.
Well, they made something out of nothing then, Geelong, because Sterrett on the opposite half-forward flank really did muck things up. He should have done the instinctive thing, and that was continue on his right foot. He didn't, he hesitated. Didn't know what he was going to do. The high ball came up, but what a great effort by Poole. Playing on the wing, really made yardage to get to that ball.
Two straight kicks the difference. Flanagan bounding in against Cloak. It's the latter who wins it. Down towards Knights. Couches on his hammer. Gale tries to soccer off the ground. Mitchell wide. Sprinting through half forward. A searching hand pass down towards the half forward flank. Pickering gives it away to Ryan. Ryan from 25 metres. Oh. Loses it, regains it, comes round onto the left foot, kicks in towards full forward, it goes over the top and hits the post again. And they're going to have a good look at these posts because they've received a lot of treatment today.
Gee, they'll have to tighten up around the outside of the square, Geelong, because Richmond taking it out. Also, Flanagan will have to lift his game in the centre and use a bit of muscle to get the ball out.
Rogers kicks in. Grandstand side, Stephen Ryan fisting away. Michael Pickering content to let it run out of bounds. So, set for a big finish. 12 points the difference. Just over 13 and a half minutes remaining. Cloak, Hocking, the quick hand pass away. Cameron towards midfield and Hamilton. Powell again, his master, thumping it away and follows up with Dash, collides with Mitchell. Down he goes, Powell, shovels it out. Hamilton, Richmond's Hamilton, that was in trouble. Mitchell at close quarters, down goes Nixon. And it'll be a ball up.
And you love the cry of ball.
Sounds fantastic, doesn't it? You know you're at the footy.
It's a good decision by the umpire then, because Nixon went forward. It really wasn't a push. It was a good decision by the umpire to ball it up.
Rucks go at it. Lee just on the ground. Hamilton, a sense of humour, kicked it back into the pack. His namesake hooks it around the outer side. Awkward bounce for Nixon. Hughes again with strength. Superbly done. Out of trouble. Inspirational stuff. Hughes long down towards Poole. Goodwin gets back and gets a fist on it.
No, there's a coming free back. Kick. I think it's coming back. It's against Hughes.
Running too far.
He should have again done the instinctive thing. He was on the right foot. He should have just hammered it down. You can't afford to do what he did then because the forwards already made position.
Bannock. A brief lull. Bannock hoisted high. Lee's in front. Flanagan over the top. Knocked on by Cameron. Couch has got it now. Hamilton the run of it on his wrong foot. Pulls it back. Poole comes over the top. Great mark in front. Justin Pickering.
Good mark.
Second half. Kardinia Park has everything. Pickering to Waitman.
Good mark.
Another strong mark. Scott McKellar running wide. To the half forward line. McCrabb. Two grabs. Couldn't take it. Gale gets the hand pass towards Knights, who's running down the middle. With him is Pickering. Out the back is Buse. Andrew Buse is everywhere. Again. He steadies and goes onto his opposite foot. Powell couldn't take it cleanly. Scott over the top. Knights in again. Scott. Couch. Can't get away. Look at the desperation.
Oh,
almost thrown out. Eventually it's Waitman. Can he get clear of Morgan? He does. And finds McKellar on centre wing. They've gone nowhere, but the pressure is intense. This time he centres it. Hogg comes out. McCrabb, a good mark. Austin McCrabb. Plays on to Brownless. Lumbers away. Might get caught. Gets his kick towards Steinem and Poole. Trevor Poole. Not paid. Play on is the call. Steinem hooks it back in towards full forward. Hickley. Great fly, but couldn't take it. McKellar towards the boundary line. Steinem. A shot. A behind.
What fantastic football
it was.
To wonder what they're doing. You wonder when you see players doing what they're doing now. What were they doing for three quarters prior?
Well, in fairness, for two. Third one wasn't too bad.
Well, as far as Richmond are concerned, but Geelong have never slipped it all day until now.
Yeah, you're right. Here's Bannock then. It's 11 points. The Tigers lead. Couch will come from behind, knocking forward again, exposed at the front of the pack. Here's Scott, snaps. Cameron goes in, ricochets off Nixon. Morgan misses.
Wrong opening.
Well, there is a definite problem down there when Richmond kicked the ball in. Bannock, who I think is manned up against the Rovers, has them get up the ground under the pack that he kicks to. We've seen that about three or four times today. Maybe being harsh on him, but certainly they're not sorting it out down there. Bannock to kick in again. In the opposite pocket, there's a man on. That's Cameron. That time the ball goes to Powell.
At half back. 10 points the margin, favouring the Tigers. Geelong trying to come home. Gurry couldn't complete the mark. Waitman down in front. Gets it out wide towards Gale. He's under pressure, loses it. Gurry's under pressure. Hamilton picks it up. Flicking it back towards the half forward line. Couch goes steaming through, but loses the football. Powell pushes along in front. Well played by the youngster. Behind him is Stoneham. Neither can take it. Now Nichols a charge. Runs his full distance. Kicks it towards full forward. A chance for Hogg. He could go over the top with a hand pass. Alex to take the kick. It looks pretty good. Richmond a goal.
But Geelong now. Lee, Couch, grabbed by Knights. Flanagan was in the back, yes. So it's going to be a free kick to Young.
And Flanagan not too good. He's hobbling. He's their only ruckman, Geelong.
Young wobbles one towards half forward. Brownless misses the mark. Melichelis does well. Nicely done. Melichelis away. They need a goal. Hughes, who better to go to? Couldn't hang on that time. Bannock did superbly. Got it out to Lee. Shovels the hand pass back to Bannock. Bannock goes down towards the pocket. Not a particularly good kick. Hugging the boundary line. McCrabb finessing. Tries to give it across to support. And the ball spills out of bounds in front of the scoreboard. That shows Richmond 12-16. Geelong 8-24. There's the time remaining. Brownless and Gale go at it. Body to body. Away comes Cameron with dash.
Kicks in towards the centre. Flanagan's there. Takes it at the second grab.
Should go long.
Still time for Geelong if they're good enough. But he's from a standing start. Going to pump it long. Down towards the 50-metre line. Free Stoneham. Kick. Gives away the free.
Good positioning by Lee at that stage.
And Mark Lee has done the job with David Cloak today for the Tigers. To kick from halfback. The general steadies things down. Goes in towards the centre. McCrabb got up high. Knights waiting down in front. Away goes Nichols again. Mitchell's the tug. Great mark. Plays on. Plays on. And loses it to Malichelis. Back towards McCrabb. Ryan defends with a fist. Flanagan trying to get some pace. Gets the hand pass out to McCrabb. Geelong again a chance. But he goes short. Pressure on Scott. Now Stoneham. Got to weave his way through. Oh, unbelievable. Hamilton's going to lose it to Nixon. Stoneham again crunches in over the top, looking to make amends. Scott on the boundary line. Close to the boundary line. Paul, was he pushed?
It's a free kick, yes. You've got to make a legitimate attempt when you're going for the ball. A lot of players in the past weeks have got away with that. Goodwin was pinged. But at least the umpires are consistent. Make an effort to go for the ball.
Trevor Poole has kicked one goal. That was earlier in this quarter.
From a difficult angle too.
And if ever they needed it, it's now.
Oh,
that's a great looking kick. Oh, the Cats are still trying to claw their way back. Poole kicks his second. It's Geelong's ninth. And again, the margin is 10 points.
Well, he started at full forward. He was moved down to the back line. Now on a centre wing. He kicked a difficult goal before when he made yardage to take a mark, a diving mark. That was a very difficult kick from out wide, very difficult angle and a long way out. A great kick from goal from the wingman.
Plenty of time still. 10 points the difference. Back in the centre. The crowded fever pitch. Lee over the top towards half forward. Hocking knocking away. It comes back to him. Hocking goes down. He's over the ball. Big ugly back. Lost it. Holding the ball, says the umpire. Gee, that's a tough one.
Well, they've got to be consistent, and they are consistent, the umpires.
Here's Gale. Long. Hog on the lead. Great mark over Couch. What a splendid mark. He's kicked 3 goals.
Well, he had the drop on that occasion, Hogg. He had the drop, he had the run. Couch had to hold his ground, which he did do. And used as a springboard or a stepboard by Hogg.
Well, if he kicks this, it'll be very tough for the Cats. A bit happening off the ball. That's done with now. And Hogg, the game riding on this kick, perhaps. From 45 metres. It looks good. It splits the middle.
Under 6 minutes remaining. Back in the centre, Lee stands his ground. Almost took it out, but it's Buse. Has been a great trier for Geelong all day. Kicks down towards the left forward pocket. Bannock wants to hit for the boundary line, but he overruns it. Thrown into half forward. Here's a chance for Couch. He gets round onto his left foot. Pumping it long in towards goal, but pulling it too far, and you guessed it, yet another behind. That is their 25th. 9:25. Trailing by 15 points. McKellar. Where will they go this time? Pickering's the target. Got to beat 3 Geelong players. Couch twists beautifully out. Gives it across to Morgan. Morgan to Scott. Scott from a standing start pulls it to the left.
Put him under a lot of pressure on that occasion. That's why he had to chip the ball. He realised the Richmond fellows were bearing down on him. And that is a 26th point. Darren Morgan.
Bannock again. Straight down the middle. Good looking kick. Nixon. Stoner. Nichols. Setting it wide. Powell's away. 2 bounces. Buse shepherded out of it by Hamilton.
Oh, He's done his ankle, Buse.
Buse is gone.
He's badly hurt.
Tried so hard for them all day. Brownless has it at half back to Flanagan. Couldn't take the mark. The big man recovers. Across the Couch. Urgent now for Geelong. Down towards full forward. At the back, Cameron, Pickering over the line, another behind.
Sturridge come on for Geelong, replacing Buse.
Buse was carried off, so it looks bad. He knew immediately. Call to the bench. There's the time remaining, over 4 minutes still. Clock has stopped. 13 points the difference. Whoa, what a climb by Nixon. Quiet all day, timely mark. Nichols, Ryan, Des Ryan on centre wing, has kicked a couple of goals today and has played well.
Oh,
untidy hand pass, put the mocker on him. Stephen Ryan held without it, surely, no free kick, and there'll be a ball up.
Well, as an experience on that occasion, Des Ryan had the ball looking for his brother Stephen, but Stephen was more interested in shepherding off the ball, should have been running down the ground.
Des Ryan has kicked 3. Lee charges after that one. In goes Mitchell. Morgan, still time for Geelong. Lovely hand pass. Hamilton across to Couch. Now Couch is away. Towards half forward. Hinkley on the lead has taken this one. Running into open space is Cameron. He pops it out in front. Coming down is Poole. Up he goes, fisted away. Justin Pickering, cleverly down. Into the path of Knights. Maybe they've weathered the storm. Knights, a third bounce, runs to centre wing, settles now, pumps it back into the forward line, setting Mitchell a task, he couldn't hang on, tackled by Darcy, comes to Hamilton, gives it away to Michael Pickering, if you don't mind, didn't see McCrabb holding the ball, says the umpire.
Austin McCrabb, under 3 minutes remaining, Wide to Hamilton. Over the centre, Scott, Stoneham. With him is Nixon. Stoneham swings round onto the left foot. Again going short.
Oh, he's a good player, Stoneham. A great player, Stoneham.
Trevor Poole from half forward. Looking for distance. Didn't quite get onto it. Cameron couldn't take the mark. Recovers. Steps with the left foot. It's high. And it is yet another behind.
Oh, he really should have put that one through. He should have put it through.
9-28 to the Tigers. 13-16. Twelve points in it. Lee. Knight through but without the ball. At the bottom was Barry Young. And we've got exactly 2 minutes remaining in this game.
Time for a tie.
Richmond have got to defend now around the boundary line. That's where the ruckman have got to hit it. Lee has got to hit towards the boundary line.
McCullough. Nichols. There's a couple of options. Looking to centre the ball. It's effective. Finding Powell. Played a great game. Kick number 18 for Powell as he goes up towards half forward and out comes Hogg at the 50-metre line.
To the half-hearted effort then by Gary.
Jeff Hogg has kicked four. Distance may test him here. But it's all time for Richmond now. Just over a minute remaining. And they look to be home. Kick going in towards the square. No mark taken. Mitchell at the back. Has to give ground before he can make any.
Good play.
And he does well as Hamilton takes the mark.
Well, Malakalis has really had his hands full with Mitchell. Although Malakalis might match him as speed, he cannot get up in the air as high as what Mitchell can. And he would be a very, very hard player to counter, Michael Mitchell. He's got explosive pace as well. And that was good play on that occasion.
Greg Hamilton in the last minute of the game. Richmond are home. There's no problems there. And what a great performance it's been. Hamilton's dropped punts on its way. May have just gone across to the right a little. It has. And one more behind goes on the ball.
As good as a goal, that one. Stops the clock, 19 seconds down Richmond's end, and they lead by 13 points. Gale got a fist on it, Flanagan's got it. Knights to Lee, ricochets across to Nichols, chips it in short, Ryan takes the mark. Des Ryan with 3 seconds to go, a chance to kick his fourth goal and make the margin 19 points. There's the siren, the Tigers have won. A massive upset at Kardinia Park. The young Tigers are victorious. And Ryan can add to the margin. Hits the post. That's happened a lot today, but a fantastic victory to Richmond. They're delighted. Richmond 13-18, Geelong 9.